This call is now being recorded.
So good morning to all. I'm Sumitra, Associate Professor, AAA Department, RMB Engineering College. I'm handling design of electrical apparatus for this semester. And in my previous video, I have explained to you what all the factors to be considered before going for a design. And also after completing a particular design, what are all the specification a design should supposed to meet, both from the customer point of view as well as the specifications laid by the government. Now in second unit, we are going to discuss about the design of transformers. So what are all the topics which is coming under the transformer unit is, so very first topic is the construction and followed by the output equation and some basics regarding the magnetic circuit calculations which requires the estimation of the no load current and also how to express the output equation in terms of the main dimension. So regarding transformer, what are all the main dimensions we have, all these things we are going to discuss in this unit. So since we have discussed a lot regarding the transformers in unit 1 and that is in missions 1 and missions 2, so just a recap, as a recap I'll give you a brief note regarding the construction. So construction means based on the construction we have three different types of transformers, like core type transformer, shell type transformer and berry type transformer. So based on the supply in which it is working, it is getting classified like single phase and three phase transformers. Again, based on the application side in which it is going to serve its function, like distribution transformer, power transformer, voltage and current transformer, like that we have so many classification. So this is the first topic in second unit. Then continuing with that is the output equation. So already I told you why there is a need to derive the output equation before going for a design. So if you are talking about a design of any machine, whether it is a static or a rotating, whether it is an AC operated one or DC operated one, we need to design only if you know the main dimensions, right? So first we need to know if it is a transformer, we all know that it will deal with the electrical voltage and current together, known as electrical power. So so our objective is to derive an equation which express the output of any particular machine in terms of the main dimension. So the objective of going for the derivation of output equation is to derive the output of that particular machine in terms of its main dimension. So now the equation which gives such a relation between the kVA output of a transformer to that of the main dimensions like area of the core and window is called output equation. So in transformers, since we know that the output is expressed in kVA, it also depends on the flux density in the ampere terms. So let me explain how to come out with the derivation of a single phase transformer and three phase transformer in this video. So here is the schematic representation for your core type and shell type transformers. And a transformer is said to have different parts like a core and the yoke. The top and the bottom horizontal sections are known as the yoke, and the two vertical sections are known as the limb or the core. Okay, and in general, next to the core always you'll be placing the low voltage winding followed by the high voltage winding. Many of the students will think that the windings, like primary winding, is placed in one separate limb and the secondary winding is placed in some other limb. Not like that. Actually speaking, in a single limb we are going to place the low voltage winding next to the core followed by the high voltage winding. Like that only each and every limb in your transformer is going to have a windings. Okay, so now if it is a single phase transformer, we have a single window. So window is the one which is the area which presents between the two limbs, right? So now this is the window section. Okay, now coming to the derivation part, we have to start with the EMF equation. As we all know that the EMF equation is the one for a primary, which we can refer either for a primary or the secondary, or in general means it become E phase is equal to 4.44 F Im into D phase. Okay. Now, I can also able to determine what is the EMF induced per turn. The above mentioned equation is the EMF induced either in terms of a primary winding or secondary winding. A winding is the one which is said to have so many number of turns, right? So if you know the EMF induced in any winding, at the same time I can able to determine what is the EMF induced per turn. So by using the equation, ET is equal to E by D. So where ET is the EMF induced per turn and E is the total induced EMF in that particular winding and T is the respective number of turns in that winding. Okay. So now, as we all know that the window in a single phase transformer contains only one primary and one secondary winding. And also we have a factor called the window space factor, which gives the ratio between the copper area to the window area. From that, I'll be getting my copper area in the window. That is AC is equal to KW into AW. At the same time, I can also able to represent my current density del as a ratio between the current to the respective area of the conductor. So which will be for a primary winding given by AP equal to IP by del, and for the secondary winding, the area of the cross section AS is equal to IS by del. And assuming the magnetizing MMF is very negligible, then we can assume that the primary ampere turns is equal to the secondary ampere turns. It means that whatever MMF is required for magnetizing the primary winding is equivalent to that one which is required for the secondary winding. So on assuming that, I can equate my AT is equal to IPTP, which is equal to ISTS. Where this IPTP and ISTS are the representation for the MMF. And also we know that MMF is nothing but the product of the current and the respective number of turns. Okay. So now coming to the derivation again, continuing with that, the total copper area and the window. So the copper area and the window, since the window consists of both the primary and the secondary, the total copper area and the window can be obtained by adding the copper area and the primary winding together with the copper area of the secondary winding. So from the above expression, I can represent my copper area in the window, that is the primary winding is equal to TPAP, and in the secondary winding is equal to TP into AS, and whereas AP and AS can be replaced by IP by del and AS by del. So on replacing all the above things, finally I'll be coming out with an expression for my copper area as 2AP by del. Already I have an expression for the copper area which is equivalent to KWAW, since equation number 2 and equation number 3 both are meaning the copper area of total copper area in the window. I can equate both the equations. On equating the equation 2 and 3, I'll be getting the expression for my ampere turn, AP is equal to 1 by 2 into KWAW del. So after getting the value of AT, just I'm going to substitute in the kVA rating of a single phase transformer. So where kVA rating is Q is equal to Vp into Ip into 10 power minus 3. Again here Vp stands for the voltage induced in the primary winding. So now since I have an expression for the EMF induced per turn, I'm going to replace this Vp by Ep by Tp, which is nothing but the EMF induced in a single turn. So the equation will become Q is equal to Et into Ap into 10 power minus 3. So the final expression is 2.22 F BM AI. So how this BM and AI came means expression is having phi M, where phi M is the flux induced in the core. And also we have an expression like BM is equal to phi M by AI. So I can replace this phi M by the product of BM and AI. So why I'm doing like this is the objective of the output equation is to represent the output in terms of the main dimension. So that's why the final equation for a single phase transformer is coming as 2.22 F BM AI KW AW del into 10 power minus 3, where BM is the maximum flux density in the core and AI is the area of the ion path and KW is the window space factor and AW is the area of the window and del is the current density. So now similarly for a three-phase transformer also we can able to derive the same output equation, but the only difference is that in case of single-phase transformer you will be having only one window, but in case of three-phase transformer, whatever may be the type, a shell type or the core type, you will be having two windows. So the difference in calculation or difference in derivation of the output equations, that instead of considering one window area, here we need to consider two window area. So each and every single window in turn consists of both the primary and the secondary. That's the only change is required in order to come out with the equation for your three-phase transformer. Again, I'm going with the same EMF equation followed by EMF per turn, and then the expression for the conductor area and window and current density, everything. So now directly if I'm moving to the calculation of total copper area and window, it becomes AC is equal to copper area of primary winding plus copper area of secondary winding, right? So on substituting the above, I told you, know it consists of two primary winding and two secondary winding since we have two windows over there. So finally you're getting the total copper area and window as 480 by del, which was 280 by del in case of a single phase transformer. So after getting this, again I'm going to equate the equations, which is having an expression for the total copper area in window. On equating that, I'll be getting an expression for AP, which is equal to 1 by 4 kW AW into del. So after getting the value of AP, just I'm going to substitute in my EMF per turn equation. So Q is equal to 3 Vp. Why this 3 arises means, since it is a three phase transformer, the output Q is equal to 3 Vp Ip. Again, I am going to replace this Vp by Ep by Tp, and then this Ep by Tp can be replaced by Et, and then the product of Tp and Ip can be replaced by At. This is the MMF. MMF can be represented by At. Now, in the previous step, I got the value of my At, which is equal to 1 by 4 into Kw Aw del. Just by substituting that, I can able to come out with the expression for my three phase transformer, like Q is equal to 3.334 Fm Kw Aw del into 10 power minus 3. Again, this phi m can be replaced by bm into ai. So the final expression will be Q is equal to 3.33 f bm ai kw aw del into 10 power minus 3. So in the next session, I'll be explaining you what all the main dimensions we need to consider regarding your transformer and how to decide the factors for selection of each and every core dimensions.